What's up, everyone? It's Jeremy Duane here, bringing you episode 14 of my Mac and Out series, where I bring you weekly update videos on my progress towards Max and Completion Escape in RuneScape. Now, today, I have quite a few level ups for you guys, and this is going to be a longer episode. I'm going to try to talk it out, but I just want to give you, an update on what's going on and, what levels I've gotten and what is going to be coming up in the next week or so. The tentative plan. It's not necessarily going to happen. But in the background, you'll just be watching some clips of me getting the level ups. And it's not live commentary or anything. And the audio that I'm recording right now might not match up exactly what is happening in the background. So just kind of keep that in mind and don't leave comments saying, "It doesn't match, the audio is off." Because I know it's off, because I recorded it off. Anyways, so you're watching me get 98 attack here. I'll be getting that in just a second. And with 98 attack, I'm one level off 99 attack. So I am also going to be getting 99 attack probably about this week, somewhere around there. We'll see. Probably going to try to train it out today, and it might happen tomorrow, which would be Thursday, March 22nd. If not Thursday, it'll happen on Friday. So keep an eye out for the live stream announcement video, because I'll be broadcasting this on my YouTube channel. It'll say Jeremy Duane IRL is broadcasting, and then it'll say 99 attack party or whatever. And yay, 98 attack. And with that, I got combat 136, which is pretty awesome. Two more combat levels to go for max combat. And I'm going to be doing this. I'm going to be getting 99 attack and 99 defense by killing these skeletal monkeys, or monkey skeletons, whatever you want to call them, because it's just fast, easy AFKable XP, and I'm all about being efficient. And I could be doing Slayer and boring myself to death, but why do that when I can just get it easy this way and watch Netflix or watch whatever on TV while I do it? So this next level up is 96 defense. And you may be saying, why are you training defense? You shouldn't be training defense, and you should be focusing on attack. Well, I didn't actually purposely get defense up. I barraged a lot of rock lobsters so that I could buy my pack yak. 96 summoning. So I was barraging rock lobsters pretty much all last week. On Thursday, I barraged rock lobsters for literally like 12 hours nonstop. I was down there. It was ridiculous. I wanted to kill myself afterwards, but I managed to get just under just about 2k Crimson Charms that day. So it was worth it, because in the end, I got my yak on Friday, which you'll see in the clips and coming up. But the reason why I got defense XP is because I was defense casting, and because I have 99 magic, I have 99 HP. So I basically just went for the defense XP, and as you can see, I'm pretty much out in this clip. This wasn't the clip that I got on Friday. I got this a couple days before that, but as you can see, 755 Crimson Charms that trip, pretty good. I'm not gonna say that it's amazing defense XP or amazing charms, but if you have the money, it's a pretty easy way to get charms. It's about 220 to 230 Crimson Charms per hour, so that'll kind of give you an idea on what kind of charms you should be getting. Eventually, I will be putting up a guide on how to kill rock lobsters for charms, because it's just a really good way to get Crimson Charms and charms in general for training summoning. And now that I've talked about getting charms, why not show you the clips of me getting summoning levels? So this weekend was bonus experience weekend, as most of you should know. If you don't know, that's kind of fail on your part, because you missed out on some awesome XP. I did a lot of training. Now, I didn't start off with summoning, because as most of you should know, summoning XP over bonus XP experience weekend was capped at 1.1 multiplier, so that's only 10%. Now, that's not a huge boost, but it's better than nothing. So what I did was I trained crafting all the way up until about 1.3 multiplier. I got so bored of crafting that I'm like, screw it, I'm just gonna go train summoning, I don't care. So I went and trained summoning, and you just saw me get 94, and I also get 95 and 96. So I got my yak, yay! It finally happened, I finally got it, and I'm very excited about this because the pack yak is amazing. I've used it so much this past week, like the weekend slash, till today, and it's so nice to have a yak for skilling, for bossing, for slayer, whatever. It's just so nice to have it because, like at Bandos, for example, if we get, when we get kills, we get bones and there's charms and other small drops like rune plate bodies, rune two hands. And it's nice to be able to just bank those items right away instead of having to make room for it in, your inventory or whatever. You can just bank it and then, you're great. You're good to go and you can stay longer. And, along with that, you can also store a lot more supplies in your yak. So now that I have my yak, I'm going to be going for the new Tokar Kal cape, which is the new fire cape. I think that's what it's called. Don't yell at me if I'm wrong. But that is what I'm going to be going for because it's really good cape to have. I'm going to be trying to get two of them, depending on how well the first one goes. And if it goes well, then I might try it again. If it doesn't go well, then I'm not gonna do it. But I'll just keep going until I get at least two of them, so I have a bank placeholder, and that'll be kind of the next major goal that I'm going for at the moment. You're seeing me kind of failing at the bank right now because I was trying to calculate it exactly so that I didn't waste any Crimson Charms. I wanted to get the exact amount of Swamp Titan pouches to get level 95. But yeah, so expect a video of me or a live stream of me doing the new fight kiln. I have all the requirements to do it, I just have to do it. And in the clips after summoning, you'll see me getting some Dungeoneering XP. And I get a very special item it'll help me out a lot throughout the fight kiln. So that is the plan. It is fight kiln very soon because I have pack yak. So this next clip is me getting my pack yak. It's pretty nice. I'm so happy that I finally got it. And the first I'm gonna actually cut out this recording of me training or talking, and I'm gonna let you listen to me in the game because it's pretty funny. But I'm so happy that I finally got my pack yak, and go ahead and enjoy this live commentary from the live stream that I did on Friday over Bonus Experience Weekend. I'm taking a screenshot of me and Barry because this is my first pack yak, and his name is Barry, and he will always be my Barry. Barry the Baruru. Nice. Oh, and on top of that, 137 combat. Yes. Yes. Okay, so continuing on. Today, or in this clip, you're seeing me get 78 runecrafting. That's right. Trying to get back into, doing my penguin points and the daily jack of trades because I do need to get runecrafting up, and I will not be doing actual runecrafting because it just is so bad. Jagex needs to fix this skill. I'm really looking forward to getting or to the new runecrafting mini game that they plan on releasing. So that's what I'm gonna actually try. I'm gonna try that and then possibly get into actually training runecrafting. So Dungeoneering, yes, there's 96 Dungeoneering right there. I've been doing quite a bit of Dungeoneering lately with some friends and with. I tried to do random groups, but I just can't do it. So I've been doing a lot of Dungeoneering. You saw me just get 96 there, and in the next clip you'll see me get 97, and then the next clip after that will be a very special item that I talked about earlier. So I plan on getting 99 Dungeoneering very, very soon. I'm like 2.2 mil XP off of 99, so it's gonna be very easy to get. Dungeoneering is actually very fast XP when you get up to the higher Dungeoneering levels. So it's gonna happen, in the next week or two. It just depends on how many teams I can get. I don't like Dungeoneering with random teams, so I really want to dungeon with friends and stuff. So that last floor that you just watched right now, when I got 97, was a pretty failed floor. We couldn't finish all the doors because we didn't have the stat requirements and stuff. But sorry for the quality of this clip, but I accidentally recorded in 1080p instead of 720p, and I was having issues in this editing software, so I'm just gonna have to deal with it how it is. But this is me getting da 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 Chaotic Kite Shield. Yep, I finally got my Chaotic Kite Shield. If you're wondering what order I got my Chaotics, I got my Rapier first, then I got my Chaotic Crossbow, then I got Rigor, the Prayer, and then I got my Eaglight Kite, and then finally I just am purchasing my Chaotic Kite Shield now. So that's about five Chaotics. I know technically the Rigor Prayer isn't a Chaotic, but it's kind of considered in that higher tier of Dungeoneering rewards. And why did I buy a Chaotic Kite Shield? I got a Chaotic Kite Shield so that I can do more solo bosses like Bandos or Zami or something like that. The Chaotic Kite Shield is pretty much a substitute for a Divine or an Ellie, so I'm gonna be using that until I can get my own Divine or whatever. So now you're watching me getting some Agility XP. This is during a live stream that I did about a week or two ago. I can't remember what I was doing before this, but I decided to go ahead and do some agility afterwards because we were still having fun in the live stream. So I did some training, and I kind of am doing agility whenever I have like just some spare time. I'm in a Skype call or whatever, and I'm in the mood for it. I'll just train some agility because it's pretty easy. And along with that, one of my kind of temporary goals with agility is to get the full agile set, which is just top and bottoms, but that reduces weight quite a bit, and it comes in handy for skilling, for runecrafting if I were to ever do that. For questing, it's very nice. So I plan on working towards that, which requires about 90 agility because you can boost up at 90 to do the Fremnic barbarian course at 95. So I'm planning on I'm training agility to like get that, and then the full agile will kind of become my next skilling outfit. And okay, so the next clips are just clips of me training agility or training crafting. Now I did say that I was planning on getting 99 crafting this weekend over bonus XP weekend, but I kind of failed with my math. I ended up only getting to 94 over the weekend, but in this video you'll see me get to 95 because I don't know what happened. I must have just been tired when I did the calculations, but maybe I just didn't train crafting long enough. But I only got to 94 over bonus XP weekend, and then I just kept training crafting. Or no, I got to 93. And then I got 94 the next day, and then 95 the day after that on Monday? Or yesterday? I got yesterday, which is Tuesday, I think. I don't remember. But I got to 95 crafting, and I do still plan on getting to 99. I just will have to do it normally, which is kind of lame. But, whatever. Whenever I'm bank standing, I'm training crafting now. Because I do a lot of bank standing. Sometimes I find myself on RuneScape and I just don't know what to do. So I stand there, I talk to friends on Skype, I talk to friends in game, I talk with my friends chat. But since I have crafting banked, I can just sit there and train crafting while while I wait for me to figure out what to do. So, 99 crafting will probably happen in the next week or two. I'm 95 at the moment. I don't know when exactly 99 is going to happen, but be sure, don't worry. I will announce it, and we will do a live stream when I get it. I like to get my 99s in live streams, because then you guys kind of feel like you're part of it. Over bonus XP weekend, I feel like it's something that they kind of screwed up. I like bonus XP weekend, don't get me wrong. It's something that's great for the community, and it helps people get back into the game, helps people train. But the thing that I don't like about bonus XP weekend is it screws up the economy a little bit. And for example, in the past, most items go up for bonus XP weekend, but this year they just everything crashed. It was very weird. But all in all, it's great. It's a great way to do it. But I think I would much prefer if they did like a specific skill, for the weekend. For example, they had that triple slayer XP day. That was amazing. They need to do that more often, stuff like that. Or, like the more loot equals more woot weekend, where you got double dunge XP and tokens, and also at the same time you got double drops from everything in the game. So, that weekend I got to 95 dungeoneering from like 92, and I also got a double Arma Chainskirt drop solo. So, I made a lot of money and I got a lot of XP that weekend. So I think JGX needs to do more things like that, where it's specific skills or specific things that just help people get into the game more. For example, they had the triple rewards for, or I think it was either triple or double rewards for like Castle Wars, for Penguin points, for like Soul Wars and stuff like that. They had specific things, and I think they need to do more things like that instead of having like the Squeal of Fortune type thing, where it's just trying to grab the membership instead of trying to just get people interested in actually playing the game. So that's kind of my thoughts on these bonus XP events that JGX does. Take it for what you want. It's just my opinion. It's not necessarily the way that everything has to be. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll have some more videos out for you soon, and we will see you later. My name is Jeremy Duane. Peace.